By the end of this episode, you will know how to code a dynamic NPC system from which the player can get quests. Let's get right into it. Let's start by creating the master NPC blueprint, which we'll inherit from the pawn class. The only thing that we will do in this class is add a new interface with a function called interact. This will let us define how the player interacts with the NPC in each child class individually. Now from this master class, derive a child called NPC quest. Now in here, create a variable called quests of type NPC quest holder and make it instance editable so we can edit this variable per instance in any level. Now we need to give each trigger the quest and step they represent. To do that, on begin play we will iterate with a for each loop over all the quests by splitting this struct, then also break the array element struct and also iterate over all the quest steps. And for the last time, let's break this struct as well. Alright, on loop body, check if the trigger is valid, and if it is, set the trigger's quest name to the quest name output of the first loop, and the step to the array element of the second loop. Did that make any sense? Let me know in the comments. Next, let's create the quest acceptance screen. In the HUD class, you have to put together something similar to this. Basically, two text blocks for the quest name and description, and two buttons parented to a horizontal box to accept or decline the quest. All of these parented to a canvas panel. Now set its default render opacity to 0 and create a fade animation. In the event graph, add an event called openInfo with 3 inputs. A boolean called close, a string called name, and another one called description. First, we will check if close is true. From false, set the visibility of the horizontal box to visible and set the text of the two text blocks using the string input to display the correct data to the player. Then play the fade animation, show the cursor and set the input mode to UI only, focusing on self. Also, if you haven't set focusable to true in class defaults, then make sure to. If close is true, set the visibility of the horizontal box to non-hit testable, self and all children, so we can't press the buttons more than once. Then play the fade animation in reverse, and after a delay equal to the length of the animation, hide the cursor and set the input mode to game only. Let's set up the onPressed event for the two buttons. But first, create a dispatcher called AcceptQuest, which will be very useful in just a bit. On pressing accept, call this dispatcher and call openInfo with close true. Don't worry about the strings, as we don't use them as long as close is true. On pressing decline, just call openInfo with close true. Now we need a way to interact with NPCs. For this, go to Edit, Project Settings, Input, and let's add an action mapping called Interact, bound to E. In the third person character, get the new input action, and from pressed, we will do the classic line trace setup that will fire a trace 450 units in front of the camera. If it hits anything, using the hit actor, cast to NPC Master and call Interact. And because the NPC Quest class is a child of NPC Master, the cast will still be successful. Now let's create an event called Ask for Quest with an NPC Quest actor reference as input. You will see why this is important in a bit. In NPC Quest, go to Interfaces, right click on Interact and click on Implement Function. For this, first we will check if there are any more quests left. If that's true, check if the quest on the 0th index can be accepted. If that is also true, cast to the third person character and call Ask for Quest, supplying the input with self. For that function, first promote the input to a variable called QuestNPC. We will use this later when accepting a quest. To show the player that the interaction was successful, from HUD call openInfo with close false and supply the name and description with data from the 0th quest in the quests array of the NPC. Now we have to add the NPC's quest to the quest component by using the dispatcher in the HUD class. On begin play, after adding the quest to viewport, bind the new event to the accept quest dispatcher. This way, when the accept button is pressed, that event will fire as well. From this event, get the quest component and call add quest. The quest is going to be the 0th quest from the NPC variable we just created, which we will also remove from its array so we won't accidentally get it twice. And it is finally time to test everything we have done so far. Let's create a trigger child. Add a sphere collision and on begin overlap if the other actor is the player, call finish step. Then add a quest NPC and two of these triggers in the level, and in the NPC add a quest, give it a name and a description, and I will add one step for each trigger. And now let's play. So we'll go up close, press E, accept the quest, let's check the quest list, there it is. Now to complete the quest, we will first get in the left sphere, and then in the right sphere, and there it is. And make sure to let me know down below, how many types of triggers do you think you can create? Can't wait to see what you guys will say. In the next episode, you will learn how to save and load everything we have created so far, so stay tuned for that. If you enjoyed this episode, then consider hitting that subscribe button to support my work. As well, make sure to leave a like if you like the series so far. Huge shout out to all my patrons for supporting me, and especially to these top tier supporters: Avirama FM, Badar Al-Kakhtani, Giovanni Pena, Golden Glowmaster, Leonardo Pereira, and Realitats Verlust. Now make sure to go and watch the next episode or the previous episode right here. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.